shoulda never gave up on me. Remember, I ain't had no views, they ain't players. Mixed emotions, got teary eyed when I wrote this. What's up, gang? It's Money Making Monday today, man. And I'm just here with a video to tell y'all I'm not working no more Saturdays, bro. I'm just tired as hell. I ain't gonna lie to you. But it's my fault, you know what I'm saying? I had a good week last week. Like, it wasn't too much. I did some good mileage. I didn't have to do no double loads because the first load was good enough that it just about took up my day. So that was cool. I was able to get back to the DC every day last week, which is also cool, you know. But then Thursday, they be calling sometimes and they be like, you know, you want to come in Saturday. So I'm having a good week and I'm like, shit, I was low-key waiting on the call. And I'm like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? I come in on Thursday. He like, you know, they offer $200, an extra $200 if you come in on your one of your off days. It could have been Saturday or Sunday. And that whatever miles you do, they're going to throw an extra $200 on top of that. Shit, I don't even know if I should have just said that. Motherfucker get on here like, these motherfuckers offer me $75. But no, they just offer you an extra $200. I'm pretty sure everybody get the $200 offer. Shit, I might be getting lowball. Somebody probably get $300. Who knows? But yeah, they offered it and I was excited. So I took it. Then Saturday came and I'm like, shit, I was mad as hell. I was just laying like, why your stupid ass had to say that you was gonna come in Saturday? I was tired as hell, gang. And I don't really more so think it was like, oh, I'm finna fall asleep tired. It was, I'm sick of this shit. I'm tired of this shit. I don't wanna do this shit today. You know what I'm saying? And that's just what type of tired I think it was. Like, I just wasn't feeling hooking up to no trailer and doing no load. And they originally gave me 475 miles. And I'm like, man, can y'all give me something smaller? Cause only because two reasons. For one, I didn't feel like doing no big ass load like that. And two, I wasn't sure if I was gonna be able to really make it back in time. So I didn't feel like chancing it or stressing it. And then I asked for it. And he gave me another load, but it basically was 300 miles. I'm like, all right, cool. You know what I'm saying? I can knock that out. And I think I got done about 2 o'clock on Saturday. I started at like 5. I started at 5 and got done at 2. I was so tired, man. I'm just like in the driver's seat, tired. Like, man, I'm just ready to get back. I'm like looking to the side of shit. This is how I'm driving, gang. Dead as hell. But I was alive, though. You know what I'm saying? But I was dead as hell at the same time. My back goddamn hurting. And then you know when you come in on your off day, everything irritates you. You just like, I shouldn't even be here today. You know what I'm saying? It's my off day. I ain't supposed to be here. The people didn't come open the door right away. That shit annoyed the hell out of me, gang. I had to go in the store, ask like 5 different people. They ain't know who the receiving lead person was. Then I had to go to service and they finally got somebody for me to get back there. And then I just really was mad to say about that. Like, y'all waste too much time. Then I had to do a back call. I'm starting to feel like when they call you to come in on your off day, they just got a lot of back calls. Cause I ain't do no back calls last week. I barely do back calls. I ain't gonna lie to you. But I only worked 2 Saturdays. So this Saturday that I just worked, I did a back call. And the first Saturday that I worked, I worked 3 Saturdays. The second Saturday I worked, I did a back call. And yeah, man. Them back calls, they cool. But, you know, sometimes you just feel like, man, this shit shouldn't even be involved in what I got going on. You know what I'm saying? It's like one of them, when you apply to be a cashier, and then your manager be like, all right, can you go mop the bathroom? You like, this shit, that ain't my job. I ain't applied for that. Not saying that back house is not my job. That's just how I be feeling sometimes. Because that's just one of them things that my recruiter didn't tell me, but in orientation they told you. So I'm already hired on and all that or whatever. And you got some drivers who don't even like to do back house. They want to do strictly what they do, you know, going to Walmart and coming back. I remember a guy commented on here when I was at the Best Buy, Warner. He said that at least you still going to the stores. I'm just doing goddamn back hauls. One of my trainers didn't like doing back hauls because they ain't give you a lot of miles when you do a backhaul. And backhauls just be kind of complicated. They act stupid when you get there. They don't be knowing. They don't be expecting you. There be a lot of miscommunication going on and all that. But for the most part, you know, I'm just happy I got through it. But it feel like this finna be a long ass week, because now I feel like my off day ain't gonna never come again, gang, because I done gave it up. But you know me, I'm a thug this week out. I just wanted to let y'all know I ain't doing no more Saturdays. I might not even, when I see them people call my phone, I might not even answer the phone. Martin, put me on the do not call list, put me on the do not disturb list, put me on the she ain't on that list, because I'm cool. You gotta offer me like a G. You gotta offer me a G to come in that on Saturdays. Martin, I'm a professional. I want to get paid professionally for my off days. You know what I'm saying? But that brings me to a point real quick. And folks, somebody get in my comments saying stupid shit. Talking about, they're not going to, why would they pay you for it? Y'all be goddamn, some people just be goddamn, that shit be going over y'all here. Y'all be tweaking. Y'all, some people don't be understanding jokes on this motherfucker. But bring me to a quick point. As truck drivers, bro, when we first start getting in the industry, the checks be so fat. They be so fat. We be like, damn, they paying me this. You telling me I can get this every week or mostly every week, more or a little less. It's always a little less. It's not no big ass less. You tell me I get more of this or less, if not the same, a little less or not the same. And then it's like, as the weeks go, your enthusiasm or whatever just start going down. Like, you just like, this shit not enough. It's not enough money. And I don't know why it's like that. Because coming from what most of us is probably coming from, the checks that we was getting was probably like really, really bullshit. And it's like we stopped appreciating the good checks that we be getting now. Like, it just come less and less value. Because you just realize the more money you make, it don't really too much change too much shit. You know, unless you got shit going on with your money, it don't really change too much shit in your life. You still feel like, man, I'm making all this money. I did this extra day and I still can't cover everything I need to cover. Goddamn rent still due. The car just broke down. It just be like, man, money just don't be enough sometimes. And that's something that hit me like, damn, why I'm even feeling like this 200 just ain't nothing. You know, it's just because I'm so used to it now that money just seems like regular ass minimum wage to me. I know people making less, but I'm just so used to making it now that it's just nothing. But yeah, gang, no more Saturdays for Domo G. That shit over with. I'm going to take all my days. I won't give a fuck if I'm just laying, looking at a ceiling, all that. I don't care. I don't care how bored I am. I'm not coming. I'm not doing it. I'm chilling on Saturdays. I could possibly be lying. For me to say all that, I could possibly be lying. We don't know. But yeah, gang, until next time, I'll holler at you.